Thanks for taking a break with us. I'm Mark, this is Arnon, and during today's break, we'll discuss DSPs for radar, the importance of real-time processing, and a whole lot more. But first, let's address a topic that Arnon has affectionately called the DSP ghost town. This goes back to a question we asked in our last video on if DSPs are dead. While the answer to that is a resounding no, the fact remains that much like a ghost town in the Old West, the other standalone DSP vendors have picked up stakes and moved on. So let me ask you this, Arnon. Since we both agree that the DSP is not going away and is still needed, why is TI the only major standalone DSP vendor left?
Yeah, it's an excellent question. I can't speak to why the other vendors aren't continuing to invest in DSP. We're successful in a broad variety of markets, you know, from sensors to servers. You'll hear us use that a lot. We've had a lot of success for a lot of time, allows us to invest. And I think what people don't realize is that it's not just DSP competition, right? We're competing with the best in the world of everything. So our 6.6 DSP core, the processor, is a world-class engine. And it competes with other world-class processors like Intel, like NVIDIA. And if you can't raise your game to play in that space, you know, you're just not going to get on the board.
Yeah, and there's only a few companies that you can mention who create those processors, right? Like you mentioned Intel, NVIDIA. It's a very small group. And what comes to mind here is the phrase economies of scale. Right? The level of investment it takes to create an architecture, not just the core, but the entire chip architecture that can perform at that level, it's a large investment, and there aren't many that can do that. And one of the things that allows TI to do it is we've had such success across a wide variety of markets, like you mentioned before, whether it's military and aerospace to machine vision, medical imaging, right? We play in a lot of areas. Yep. And I think if we didn't have such success in the past, we wouldn't be able to invest to the level we do. And I think that's probably why some of the competitors haven't been able to stay in the space, because they can't invest in that, because they haven't had that success.
Yeah, and I can't say I'm sorry to see them go.
No, I'm not sorry about that.
We use the term real-time processing quite often in the embedded computing world. Viewers out there may not be that familiar with embedded processing and the concept of real-time. So Mark, you know, what is real-time processing and why is it important?
Well, real-time processing at its simplest level is really being able to take in inputs, do some processing, and give a meaningful output within a specified window of time as dictated by the application. Now, if you miss this specified window of time, right, your system will fail in some way, perhaps catastrophically. A good example of this is the collision prevention systems in automotive ADAS systems, right, advanced driver assistance systems. So you take in the input and you're trying to process to determine whether or not a crash is imminent, and if it is, to apply the brakes. Now, if you miss that processing window, right, you have an accident.
Might be bad.
That's real-time processing. You can't miss it. If you do, right, catastrophic.
Yeah, and not to trivialize, but again, it shows up in things like audio and video where you got to keep up with the data coming in. You have to guarantee that things finish on time.
Sure, you get audio pops, you got frames dropping in video. Yep. Yeah, these things happen. But the key is, in order to hit hard real-time processing requirements, right, your processor and your operating system really have to be designed for it. You have to be able to take in inputs, interrupts very quickly, and act on them. And this is something that has to be done at the architectural level, right? So you have to be designed.
Yeah, one thing I think people don't realize is that the memory system on a DSP can be configured as a cache-based system, like a general purpose system, or as a, just fixed L2. You know, bring data into local memory, run directly off of it, and you can guarantee when data arrives and when you start, which you can't do on a lot of processors because, like you said, they're not built that way.
Yeah, no, that's absolutely correct. And that's something, right, DSP built architecturally for that, general purpose processors aren't.
Guaranteed on time.
That's right. Arnon, I know you visit a lot of space, avionics, and defense customers, as TI does a lot of business in this area. I know that the PowerPC architecture has traditionally been a big player here as well. What type of DSP solution does TI have as an alternative to the PowerPC in applications such as radar?
Radar is a really good application for DSPs. The FFT function, which is one of the predominant functions of processing for radars, just maps really well to DSP architectures. We do it better than anything else in the world. And PowerPCs, they had a processor engine called the AltaVec engine, which is really quite dated at this point. And the 6.6 DSPs, the benchmarks for that are far outweigh that. And then the other part of what we did is, the PowerPC had the power architecture, which, if you're following the news, isn't as invested in as it used to be. And people are moving to ARM-based processors. And we now have ARM and DSPs together on a lot of our devices. And it really helps enable the size, weight, and power, that the swap is the term in the defense industry that they're looking for radar applications, actually for a wide variety of applications in the defense market.
Okay. Well, I'm glad this question went to you, because I don't really have anything to add because I don't know this space very well. But I do know that we have a great paper that just got put on our website on synthetic aperture radar. So I would recommend downloading that if you want more information on that.
All right, so it looks like we're ready to move to the wrap-up.
Let's do it.
So, Avengers, Age of Ultron is nearly upon us, and I know you are very geeked up about this.
I couldn't be more excited. Anything Joss Whedon does is a must-see for me, so I'm really amped for this. I do think it's going to be a little darker, though. I think they're preparing for Captain America: Civil War, so a little darker. You going to take the kids to see it?
My kids are teenagers. It's a whole different conversation. They might let me go with them, but it's really not about taking them to movies at this point. Hey, you know, in a recent blog I put on the process, I talked about a Radio Shack TRS-80 computer. You know, did you have a computer? What did you have?
Yeah. In high school, I had the Commodore 64 with the tape drive. I remember I was excited when I got the disk drive because then I could play Larry Bird and Dr. Jago one-on-one.
Yeah, and I remember those floppies. You could punch a card on it, and you could use both sides, and you could save money.
Yes,
I mean,
cost
savings.
I don't
know. I don't know how many people out there remember that, but yeah, those. I'm not sure they were the good old days, but they were the old days.
So, Arnon, without having an NDA in place, what can you tell people about the future of our DSP roadmap?
Dude, you're getting all serious on me. The future of the roadmap actually is fantastic. We've been working behind the scenes on the next generation DSP core for quite some time. It's basically 90 to 95% synthesized. We're running test code on it. When the next devices come out, I mean, we'll leave that to be under NDA. Can't talk about it here, but you know, suffice it to say, it's a big step forward, and I think people will be really excited when they learn more about it.
Yeah, getting great positive feedback from people who have seen it. So if you're interested in it, sign an NDA with TI. We'd love to talk to you about it. Okay, last one unknown. What's your favorite class to play in Hearthstone?
Oh, so calling out the geek here. Yeah, priest. I like playing priest.
Really?
And a little bit of warlock and hunter.
I've been into rogue lately because of the Iron Sensei mech, but I don't really, you know, I only get to level 16 in Arena. I know you got to level 2, so you're the expert
and
here.
And this is why we cannot tell anybody about these videos.
Exactly. All right, we're out of time. Thanks for taking a break with us. Tweet us your questions and comments using the hashtag DSPBreak, and we'll address them in future videos.
As always, don't forget to follow us on Twitter. Check out ti.com/dreamdsp for all the latest info and material on TI DSPs. And Mark, I know you're dying to know what DSP stands for. Definitely simple programming.
Nice, that's very good.
Thanks. Man, see, I told you that was great. I was all over the place. You did good.